another potential new customer to serve. It wasn't until he arrived at the address to find what he can only describe as a shack that he realized that this wasn't at all what he'd had in mind. His first thought was to immediately turn around and leave, but he had promised this woman he'd come out. So he knocked on the door. When it opened, a thick smell of mildew struck his nostrils, and he was again overcome by the urge to get out of there. But as he was about to say that he probably couldn't help and leave, a 5-year-old little girl appeared beside him with a bright smile and took his hand. She was excited to show this visitor around her home, so she led him into the house. She led him through the living room and down a crowded hallway. She was most excited to show Charles her room. Upon stepping into the small bedroom, he noticed the mildew smell had intensified. On the floor lay 4 mildew-covered mattresses where this little girl and her siblings were sleeping. It was at that moment, looking at this little girl and her mother, knowing that they were in pain, that Charles knew what he had to do. He was going to help. So he climbed up on the roof to look it over. It was beyond repair. It had to be replaced. And he was going to figure out how to do it for free because it was the right thing to do. The following weekend, because he didn't have any employees yet, he rounded up 7 volunteers, and they put a donated roof on that house so that the little girl and her family didn't have to continue living in an unhealthy and unsafe home. This moment changed Charles's life and his perspective on business. While he didn't realize it at the time, it was the first time he had put people before profit.